Hey there guys, welcome back. My name's Sada Plays. I hope you're all well. In today's video, it's going to be a bit different to other videos. I'm just testing this out to see if you guys like it. I think it'll be cool for you. Today, guys, we're going to have some random footage in the background. I think it's going to be Evolve. Actually, you should check out Evolve. It's free to play now. I'll leave a link in the description. It's a very, very good game. You can be a monster or you can be hunters. They hunt each other. It's very, very cool. But anyway, today I wanted to tell you guys a story. When I was younger, I went traveling around the world for like 3 years on and off. I went to Israel, Egypt, Thailand, Vietnam, Indonesia, Malaysia, Singapore, Australia. I traveled a lot of places and I had some quite funny things happen to me. So I thought, for you guys to get to know me a little bit better, and maybe I could entertain you with some funny stories that happened to me while I was traveling. I've got a lot of these, so if you do like this sort of thing, let us know in the comments and I can carry on for you. So, the first story is when I was in Israel and I was staying on something called a kibbutz there, which is like, they call it an egalitarian society, which means an equal society. Anyway, cut a long story short, you can volunteer to stay on a kibbutz. The kibbutz is like this society thing that's supposed to be equal, and you can volunteer on it. So pretty much, it's like a load of teenagers go in there to get drunk and touch each other in funny places and work and get food for free. But anyway, it's very cool. So this first story is something that this is genuinely what happened to me 100%, and I think it might give you a little laugh. Looking back on it, it certainly gave me a little laugh. So I'm staying on this kibbutz, and one of the deals was you have to work every day on the kibbutz, and then they give you food and accommodation for you working there. So I'd done that for a few months. I worked every day. I was a really good little boy. I'd done the most shittest jobs imaginable, like washing up in this massive restaurant thing, which was just horrible. And also like folding bed sheets, like putting these bed sheets through these massive big rollers with like steam and stuff. You do that in like 40 degree heat in Israel, that after drinking a bottle of vodka the night before, that is not a good. I can literally remember standing there and like pushing these sheets through this big roller thing. All this steam comes off and I can literally remember the floor, like it felt like I was on a boat. I was just like, whoa, it was like rocking and everything. Anyway, so you're supposed to work there. And I thought it would be a good idea in my wisdom to maybe not do as much work as I was supposed to do and go to the beach instead. So what I used to do, the jobs that they allocated me to do, I used to go in to work, show my face, be like, oh, hi, yeah, I'm here to work. And then work for maybe an hour or half an hour and then pretend I was going to the toilet and just slip out and disappear. And then go to the beach all day. And I started doing this, and I was actually getting away with this for quite a long time, which was pretty sweet. Until, there was this lady called Ada. She was an Israeli lady, and she was like, what do they call it? The volunteer leader or something? I don't know. She looked after all the volunteers, which was us. And one day, she said that I had to go and meet her in her office, and I went there and she was like, oh, it's been noticed that you haven't been going to work like everybody else. I'm afraid we're gonna have to ask you to leave the kibbutz. And I was just like, what the fuck? What? Considering I'm 18 years old, this is my first time properly abroad somewhere, and I'm being kicked out of the place that I stay, and I've literally got nowhere to stay, no money, like what the fuck am I gonna do? And I was like, please, like, I've got nowhere to go. She was like, oh, you should have thought of that before you didn't go to work. So I was like, okay, I've got some friends on the kibbutz, so I could like stay with them. That'd be cool. And I did do this for a few days. And then I got... Actually, this is a whole other story, but this might be a long one, guys. So I stayed with a couple of my friends until somebody saw me leaving their little shack where I was staying. And the volunteer leader was like, oh, you saw Sada, like... I saw Sada, like, leaving this house. You, if anybody, like, takes care of Sada... Obviously, my name isn't Sada, but it could be. It'd be weird, wouldn't it? If anyone takes care of him, like, lets him stay at their house, we will kick you off the kibbutz. And so all my friends just were like, oh, shit. I don't want to be kicked off the kibbutz. I've got nowhere to go. So I couldn't stay with them anymore. I didn't know. I had nowhere to stay. So I was just like, oh, shit. Like, what am I going to do? And... there was like this big water tower thing. So I thought I could, I don't know why I thought this would be a good idea. I could sleep at the top of this water tower thing. And I had my, I left my bags in one of my friend's little shack things. And all I had was this water bottle. And I told a few guys that I was staying on top of this water tower and had this water bottle there. This is sick, guys. This is what humans can do. This is fucking sick. And there was this one guy who really didn't like me. And I used to leave my water bottle up this water tower. And then go there and sort of chill out and sleep up there. And one day, I went to my little water tower thing. And I thought my water bottle's moved. What the fuck? And, I went to like open the top of my water bottle. Somebody had pooed in there. This guy had pooed in the top of my water bottle and it had been sitting in 30 degree heat for like hours. That was not good. So that was just it. That was literally it. I was like, you motherfucker. You like pooed in my water bottle. That's game over now. So I just thought, you know what? I don't even want to stay on this kibbutz anymore. I'm gonna find my own way and survive. So literally, I'm on the streets now. I've got no money. I've got nowhere to stay. I've got a big backpack with all my stuff in it. Nowhere to store it. And my flight home is in like a month. So I was just like, what the... I had a little bit of money, but not a lot at all. Not enough to get any accommodation anywhere. So on this kibbutz that we were staying on, there was an old abandoned amphitheater, which is like one of these, I don't really know how to explain it. It's like, in Greece, they had like these stages where people used to fight at the bottom. And there's like all these steps going up. It was a thing like that. It was like a theater, but a really old one and made out of rocks and stones and stuff. So I thought, you know, it was quite secluded there. So I thought I could stay there. You know, nobody would bother me. I could sleep there. And then, like, during the day, I could, like, go to the beach and stuff. It sounded good at the time. So anyway, this is the story of one of the probably just funniest days that I spent there. And just the luck I had that day will probably make you laugh. So... what I did, I had my backpack and I sort of put it in this tree and I covered it with leaves so nobody would find my stuff. And that's what I did. I stayed there a few days. And this, what I'm about to tell you, all happened in one day. This, it was just like God looked down on me and went, oh, you're a bit of a twat, aren't you? This is going to happen to you today, Sada, and you're going to like it. I didn't like it, guys. I didn't like it. So this is just so wrong. This is one day, okay? So I went to sleep that night. I was sleeping like on this bit of concrete, like this secluded bit of concrete out the back of this amphitheater. So I woke up. This is the day of doom, as I'm going to call it. I woke up and I was like, opened my eyes and the sun was already out and the flies were buzzing around my face and I was just like, oh God, like I need some food, I need some water. And because this amphitheatre was like abandoned, there used to be loads of pigeons that used to live like up in the ceiling of it. And I literally woke up, opened my eyes, and immediately I opened my eyes. I had, at the time then, I had long hair, like a ponytail. And I literally woke up, opened my eyes, and then I just felt something like tap my ponytail. Like the hair at the back of my head, like somebody had come behind me and just slapped me on the ponytail. And then like I felt at my back, like something was on my back. I was like, what the fuck just happened? Put my hand there and a freaking pigeon from at the top of this amphitheater, as soon as I woke up, just shit on my head. It just done the most massive pigeon shit on my head. And that's how I woke up that day. So I was just like, oh my God, what the fuck? Like, I had all this pigeon poo in my hair. So I was like, wow, today is not going to be a good day. So I, like, wiped my hair. Still had bits of poo in my hair, you know. I couldn't really wash my hair, but, you know. So I got pigeon poo in my hair as soon as I woke up. And then I was like, whoa, what am I going to do today? I don't know what I'm going to do. And I was a bit bored. So I just started sitting there on this bit of concrete, like sunbathing. And then I decided it would be a good idea, because I was bored, there was nothing else to do, to get an aerosol can out of my backpack and a lighter and start burning, setting, you know, like if you get an aerosol can and you like you spray it and then you light it, it gets like a flamethrower. So I thought it would be a good idea to start burning these ants that were walking around on this bit of concrete with me to keep me entertained. So anyway, I started doing that. I was like, ksh, ksh, and I was like laughing to myself while I was doing it. I don't know, I was a bit crazy. So I'm like, psh, I was like, yeah, yeah, little fucker, like burning these ants. And then I just had a feeling, like, you know, like you get this feeling somebody's watching you. And I sort of turned round to my left, looked, and there was this guy just staring at me with his mouth open, just like with this sort of quizzical look on his face, just like, what the fuck? And just imagine if you saw somebody doing this from a distance. They've gotten, like, they're not going to know there's any ants there. They're just going to see a guy with an aerosol can, lighting it, spraying it at the ground around him, laughing and talking to himself. And this guy just walked over to me and was like, hello? And I was like, hello? He was like, are you okay? Are you on drugs? He literally thought I was a lunatic, escaped from some mental asylum or something. It was so freaking embarrassing. So anyway, he went and I was like, right, dude, I've got to get away from this amphitheatre because this guy is probably going to call the police or something or get me put in a mental hospital. Like, it just looked crazy. And I hadn't drunk anything and I hadn't eaten anything. So where the kibbutz was, it was like a really long walk, like down this dusty path to like the main town there where I could buy a drink and maybe something to eat. So I started walking along this path. I'm like, oh, it was so hot. It's Israel, so it was very, very hot. Decided to walk down this long, dusty path. I'm walking along. It's like 30 degrees. The sun is beating down on my head. My hair is literally going crispy because of the sun. My sunglasses, I've got like on this string thing around my neck. The arms on the sunglasses are like heating up because they're metal and like burning my chest. It is hot. And I suddenly thought, I'm probably dehydrating. I need to get some liquid in me. So I'm walking along this dusty path. And then I see a big cactus thing with like these fruit on it. And, you know, I've seen a few survival programs. I think I know what I'm doing. they were prickly pears. So I thought this prickly pear thing, if I pick it, and I had like a little knife, I had a little knife in like my bum bag or a fanny pack, as Americans call it. Yes, I did have a fanny pack. Fanny packs are cool, guys, by the way. So I found this prickly pear, about the size of a normal pear, really, but with prickles on. Like, load of spikes on the outside to this pear. So I thought I'd get my knife and I'd cut this thick green skin off of it, and it wouldn't have prickles in it, like on it, and I could eat it. So once I'd cut the thing off, there was just like this white, like pear thing, but it was really white, like the pith of an orange, that sort of thing. And I was like, oh, I'm just going to eat this. Like, I've got the spikes off of it, I can eat it. Took a bite out of it, like a big bite. I was so thirsty. I was expecting it to be all juicy and lovely. Took a big old bite of it. Mm-hmm. Started eating it. And to be fair, it didn't taste too bad. I was eating it. Mm-hmm. And then suddenly, I just felt in my lips and in my tongue just absolute pain. And then I was like, what the fuck is going on? Is it poisonous? Like, what the hell is going on? So I touched my lips with my fingers, and every time I pushed on my lips, it like hurt. And then I realized that inside this prickly pear was literally billions and billions of tiny little spikes, like little hairs. But they were proper, they'd stuck all in my lips, all in my tongue. Luckily, I didn't swallow it. I probably would have freaking died. And so now I like spat this thing out. I was like, oh no. And all my lips have got all these spikes in. My tongue has got all these spikes in. I've got bird poop on my head. I'm thirsty. I've been caught spraying ants with a freaking aerosol. Today is not going good. And I'm just like, oh shit, what am I going to do? I've got to get, I obviously couldn't pull these spikes out of my lips and my mouth. So I thought it would be a good idea, because I'm on this dusty, sandy path, to get a handful of sand and rub it into my lips and my tongue, which would like get these spikes out. So I was like rubbing sand in my lips, like scraping my tongue. And the sand was like all red, and it just like it stained my hands red. So it obviously must have stained the whole of my lips and the whole of my face red. So poo on my head, red mental thing all around my lips, looking like I'm a vampire. I've just killed someone. It's mental. So anyway, that didn't work out, the prickly pear thing. So I carried on walking. And I finally got to the main road. And then when I got to the main road, usually this is like a motorway, like a freeway. There's usually cars everywhere. There wasn't a car to be seen. Everywhere was just quiet. It was just dead. There was nothing. There was just the birds chirping and the sun beating down on me. And I've got red all over me and poo all over me. And I'm just like, it's like something out of some crazy zombie movie. No cars anywhere. Completely silent. So I start walking along at the edge of this freeway, heading towards town. No car. I'm walking for 10 minutes. Not a single car comes past. Carry on. Walk in 15, 20 minutes. Nothing. Everywhere silent. I am freaking out by now. I'm thinking that maybe this prickly pear I've eaten has poisoned me and I've gone mental, and maybe there are cars there and I'm going to get run over soon. I'm freaking out. I'm literally freaking out. Next thing I know, I hear this one car. And by now, I'm not walking at the side of the freeway. I'm walking in the middle of it. Just walking down the middle of this highway that's usually crazy busy. And I'm just spooking out. I don't know what the hell's going on. So I'm walking down the middle of this highway. And then I hear in the distance like a faint sound of a car coming, but really fast. And I like turn around and I could just see this little red, don't know what sort of car it was, just a tiny little red car speeding down the road. And in Israel, it's quite safe to hitch rides, like, you know, to hitchhike. And but what you have to do in Israel is point at the floor. Because if you stick your thumb up like you would in America and Europe to hitch, somebody told me, I don't know if this is true, but that is like telling someone to fuck off. If you like stick your thumb up to somebody, it's like a bad thing. So anyway, you point at the ground. Next thing I know, this car stops next to me. And I was like, oh, can I have a lift into the town? And he's some Israeli guy, and he, like a young lad. And he was like, yeah. Jump in. So I got in his car and we start driving. And I was like, what is going on? Why is there no cars anywhere? And he turned around, looked at me, and his eyes just opened like, what the fuck? Obviously, he's seen the poo in my hair. My mouth's all red. And I can't explain what's just happened to me. I just can't. And he was like, are you okay? And I was like, yeah, just a bit of a weird day. And he was like, okay. And I said, why are there no cars anywhere? What is going on? Why are you the only car on the road? He said, today is a national holiday in Israel. It's called Yom Kippur, which everybody stays in their house. You're not allowed to drive. You're not even allowed to put electricity on in your house or something like that. It's like a holy holiday, Yom Kippur. And he said, if you get seen in my car, like driving along, you're going to be, you know, people will maybe throw stones at us and be really angry. And so he was speeding along so nobody could throw stones at his car. And I was just like, oh my God, this is fucking mental. What the fuck is going on here? So I'm in his car going along, and I was like, why are you driving? Why are just you driving now? And he said, oh, I stayed around my girlfriend's last night, and I didn't realize that the next day was going to be Yom Kippur, and I have to get back to my parents. I have to do it. So I was like, okay. So anyway, he drove me into town, dropped me off, and then he just said, quick, run, as I jumped out the car. And he sped off, wheel spinned off up the road, and there was literally nobody in town there. So I was just like, what the fuck is going on? Like, so I managed to go into town. I found myself this little ice cream place that was open there. Had some ice cream, chilled out, and just relaxed. And then I finally had some food and some water, went back to my little amphitheatre where I sleep in, and then I just sat on the bit of concrete as the sun went down that night, and I just sort of looked back on my day, and I was just like, that was a mental day. That was a crazy day. And then I got an empty water bottle, used it as a pillow, and I went to sleep on that bit of concrete in Israel in the amphitheatre. That was my day, that day in Israel, when I stayed on the kibbutz. That is the end of my story, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Maybe you didn't. Maybe you thought it was weird. But I thought I would try this out just to see what you guys think. If you would like more of this sort of thing, I've got some really crazy stories, guys. That story I just told you then was like a warm-up. That wasn't even that crazy. I've got much more crazy stories to tell you. Trust me. So anyway, thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy this type of video, let me know, and I will do more for you. If not, just say, no, Sada, this was a terrible idea. Never do this again. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy the video, maybe give us a like or a comment. And I will see you guys next time.